SAS Environment Manager allows individual users to manage their own personal SAS assets and administrators to customize and monitor the SAS Viya environment for all. In this demonstration, we'll highlight a few of the administrative features at the end, but we will concentrate on the features available to all users. If you have access to SAS Viya, I encourage you to follow along with me. Your environment may already have all the files used in this demo. However, if you don't see them, please visit our SAS Software GitHub page. The SAS Viya Quick Start Repository provides the files used in our demonstrations and the instructions to load them into your environment. Start by logging in, and if you're prompted to opt in to the SAS Administrator's Assumable Groups, select No. This will limit the features in Environment Manager to those accessible by most general users. Then, from the Applications menu, select Manage Environment. Expand the left panel to display descriptions for each icon in the navigation pane. First, let's focus on content. SAS content in Viya is a centralized repository of your SAS assets, including programs, reports, flows, jobs, models, and other items. From the Content window, you can manage all your available resources. Expand SAS Content, Products, SAS Visual Analytics, and select Samples. There are three Visual Analytics reports in this folder. You can organize the content in tiles or a list. Select the Warranty Analysis report to view the details in the right pane. Expand Properties to view the report history, and expand More to view additional information. Under Related Items, we can see the input tables to the reports and link to SAS Lineage to explore a diagram that visualizes all related SAS assets, both upstream and downstream. Return to Environment Manager and switch to the Comments tab. This is a great way to collaborate with your colleagues when working with shared assets. Right-click the Warranty Analysis report to view additional options. Select Add to Favorites to create a shortcut in the My Favorites folder, or you can create a shortcut in any other folder. Select Authorization to view permissions for this item. My ID is Student, so I only have been granted permission to view the report. Click Close. You may also create new folders and add or move content. Right-click My Folder and select New Folder. Name the folder Quick-Start-SAS-Content. Right-click the new folder and select Upload and Files. If necessary, navigate to the SAS Viya Quick Start main folder, then hold down the Control key and select the Import HomeEquity.SAS program and the Prepare HomeEquity.FLW flow. Remember, SAS content is a great way to store and share your SAS assets, but is not typically used for data. Click Open. To add additional items to a folder, you can select the New icon or right-click within the folder. You can also create subfolders, add links to URLs, add shortcuts to other SAS content, or upload additional files. Select Link and type www.sas.com in the URL field and SAS website in the label field. Click OK, then double-click the new link to open the SAS webpage in a new tab. If you right-click a folder or item, you'll find several additional actions to manage and share that content. Select Share, then click the Select Names icon. You can select individual users or groups to share your content. Select the Data Builders group, click OK, confirm they will have read access, then click Share. I'd like to take a moment to talk about searching for content. The search field allows you to search for simple keywords. For example, type warranty in the search field and notice multiple assets are returned, including a report and data. Search not only returns assets in SAS content, but also tables that have been registered in SAS Information Catalog. And just like Information Catalog, the Environment Manager search also allows you to perform a faceted search. Click in the search field and notice a few facets are listed. Type asset, then select asset type. Complete the search string by typing report, then press enter. All reports that are available to me are listed. Let's move on to the other items in the navigation pane. Select servers. As a user, you can view the available servers and confirm the state is running. Click Configuration to view additional details, such as the history of your CAS sessions and CAS configuration options. Additional server settings can be updated by administrators only. Next, select Data in the navigation pane and notice that SAS Data Explorer opens. This is the centralized application to manage all data sources. SAS Data Explorer was covered thoroughly in another quick start demonstration, so I'll return to Environment Manager. Import provides a process to read various SAS 9 assets or other SAS package files and load them into the SAS Viya environment. For example, if you have a SAS Enterprise Guide project, which is a file with a .egp extension, then you can import the project and convert it to a SAS Studio Flow or a .flw file. Before we examine the monitor section, let's switch over to SAS Studio. Select the Applications menu and choose Develop Code and Flows. In the Explorer, expand Folder Shortcuts, Shortcut to My Folder, Quick Start SAS Content. The folder and files we loaded while in Environment Manager are available in SAS Studio. Right-click the Import HomeEquity.SAS program and select Schedule as a Job. Let's regularly run this program daily to automatically refresh the home equity table. Click Save. How about the flow? First, double-click Import HomeEquity.flw. Because this file hasn't been opened yet in SAS Studio, you are first prompted to associate the file with the application. Click Yes, then view the flow in the canvas. Right-click the Prepare HomeEquityData.flw file and select Deploy as a Job and Deploy. This will make the job available to execute in other applications, but will not schedule it to run routinely. Let's add one new program to simulate the need to cancel a runaway job. Write a data step that creates an infinite loop such that I will never equal 10 exactly. If we run the program in Studio, it will just keep going until we click Cancel. But what if we deploy this program as a job and run it? Save it in the Quick Start SAS Content folder as loop.sas. Then right-click loop.sas and select Deploy as a Job. While in SAS Studio, you can view and manage deployed and scheduled jobs from the View menu. However, you have even more information and control available in Environment Manager. Back in Environment Manager, select Jobs and Flows. Let's view the Scheduling tab. Notice the three jobs are listed, and the Import Home Equity job is scheduled. You may find it helpful to click the Manage Columns icon and display additional columns. I'll select all columns and click OK. Right-click Import Home Equity to view the option menu. Then select Execute. Repeat the process to execute the other two jobs. Then unschedule Import Home Equity so that it will not execute again automatically. These jobs are running independently, but what if you want to link jobs together to orchestrate a more complex process? Click New, Job Flow. In this window, you can drag and drop jobs into the flow, define dependencies and gates, set trigger events based on time or file updates, and configure error handling. To create a simple flow, drag the Import Home Equity and Prepare Home Equity Data jobs to the flow. Then click the right side of the first node and drag to the left side of the second node to connect them. You can add actions from the left pane or the More Options menu. You can also change the arrangement to vertical. Select the Job Flow Properties icon, change the name to Home Equity Job Flow, and click Save. This job flow can now be executed or scheduled. Now let's visit the Monitoring tab to view the execution status of the jobs we previously submitted. You may need to click Refresh to get the latest updates. Here you can confirm that two jobs ran successfully and the corresponding log is available. However, our loop job is still running. If you are maintaining several jobs, you can view a horizontal bar chart that provides a helpful way to visualize the status and duration of each job execution. I'll look at jobs executed in the previous hour and expand the width of the horizontal axis. The green bars represent successful jobs, and the teal bar indicates loop is still running. What's the best way to stop our infinite loop program? Let's visit Workload Orchestrator. From the user perspective, you can use the Jobs tab to view all the jobs that you have submitted. Notice the loop program has a state of running. Select the checkbox for that row, then click Stop and Update. The state value changes to killed and the job is no longer running behind the scenes. Let's move on to security and my credentials. Here you can securely store your personal credentials, including username and password, for external systems. These credentials are encrypted and associated with your user account in the SAS metadata. Click New. Then select an authentication domain, which is a logical name representing a system, such as Oracle Auth or Git Auth. Your SAS administrator can define the available domains. If you are using the SAS Virtual Learning Environment to follow along, select Oracle Auth, then type student in uppercase as the user ID, and metadata 0 with a capital M as the password. Click Save. Once credentials are stored and associated correctly, SAS can access those systems automatically during job execution, scheduled tasks, or data access. You can also reference the authentication domain name in a SAS program so that you don't need to type your credentials directly in the code. Finally, the Quality Knowledge Bases page provides an interface for managing Quality Knowledge Bases, or QKBs. QKBs are used by SAS data quality tools for performing data cleansing, standardization, parsing, matching, and other data quality operations. As a user, there isn't much I can do with this QKB other than view its properties. I've pretty much covered the features available in Environment Manager for a user, but remember there is so much more for administrators. I'll sign out of SAS Viya and sign back in, this time opting in to the SAS Administrators group. Notice there are many more items listed in the navigation pane that allow administrators to configure, monitor, and secure their SAS Viya platform. Some unique administration features include organizing users in groups, creating shared user-defined formats, working with rules for access to content and functionality, and defining security domains and publishing destinations. To learn more, click Help and visit both the Learning Center for training resources and the Help Center for complete documentation.